discussed by London Transport. Managers met today to decide whether or not to sell off the entire Red Bus fleet. Mike Pearce reports.
If the plan goes ahead, every one of London's 5,000 Red Buses will be sold to private firms or management consortiums. They'll be under no obligation to keep the buses painted red. The symbol which identifies London all over the world could disappear. Up for sale will go each of London Bus's 11 subsidiary companies for an asking price of tens of millions of pounds. In addition, all the capital's 600 bus routes may be put out to competitive tender, run by the company who can operate the best service for the least amount of money. With the deregulation of London's buses delayed, LTC the radical plan as the way forward in the meantime. But the transport workers' union say it will lead to a worse service and increased competition will put jobs and livelihoods at risk.
For bus workers, it means longer hours and lower hourly rates of pay. And this is already producing questionable standards of public safety on vehicles, sometimes in London even. It means that bus workers are pushed often into working hours in excess of those the law permits so as to keep a roof over their families' heads. It means a worse deal all round for those people who look after the buses, those people who drive the buses, and that means for those people who use them.
Around 40% of London's bus routes have so far been tendered. London Transport said it's led to improved services. The government say they still plan to deregulate London's buses. That's when any number of companies are allowed to compete on the same route. Critics say it will mean more vehicles on the roads, causing chaos like in the 1920s when the capital last saw open competition.
What we have seen is that deregulation doesn't work outside London. First of all, fares have gone up outside London, so the passenger has suffered from that point of view. Secondly, the number of passengers using buses outside London has actually gone down.
London Transport say they won't announce their decision for some time yet, although their plan to sell off the bus network and tender all their routes is to prepare for government deregulation. They'll still need permission from the Department of Transport. But it looks like London's buses will soon face their most radical shake-up for 70 years. This is Mike Pearce for Thames News.
A short time ago, I spoke to Stephen Norris, the Transport Minister for London, and asked him what will happen to London's buses.
Well, we've made no secret of the fact that we want to see privatisation and deregulation brought to London's buses because we think it's in the best interests of passengers. Quite how both of those objectives are to be achieved is still very much a matter for planning, making sure that we've dotted all the I's and crossed all the T's, and I expect to be talking with London Transport and others to make sure we do the job properly.
Well, union leaders fear that whatever happens, it will mean massive job losses, poorer services, and perhaps even a risk to safety.
I simply think they're wrong on absolutely all of those counts. On the contrary, what it will do is it will bring more and better services for people in London. It'll mean that we get lots more private sector initiative and incentive into bus operations. And as you know, where we have introduced competition and incentive in the tendered bus operations, for example, it's been immensely successful. I don't think any of these fears are real.
What about the worry of more vehicles on the road and the problems that may cause?
Well, precisely one of the reasons why we've got a deregulation consultative group set up is to look at the kind of issues that arise when you do open the market up, to make sure that when deregulation comes to London, it comes sensibly and it comes in the interests of passengers. And obviously this question of congestion on routes is exactly one we're going to address. But I would just say one thing. Buses are seldom the cause of congestion. They're generally the victims of it.
Can I ask you one final question briefly? Whatever happens, will you keep the buses red?
Actually, that's very much a question for the operators. I think they've got any sense. They'll certainly keep the buses red. It's certainly a symbol of London that people recognise. There's absolutely no reason why they shouldn't keep it that way if they want to.
Stephen Norris, thank you very much indeed.
Pleasure.
Thousands of Londoners have